This is the D-cycle, or dual-cycle engine, and it basically combines the advantages of a two-stroke and a four-stroke engine. To achieve this, various parts are added, such as the split piston. But is this engine really superior? Well, tests have been carried out with a three-cylinder Ford Fiesta and a straight-six turbo diesel military truck. So let's analyze in 3D how it works and discover its real advantages. A four-stroke engine has to make two rotations to produce power. That is to say, in the first rotation, it makes the intake and the compression stroke. Then in the second rotation, it combusts and exhaust. I repeat, two rotations are needed to burn fuel. The cylinder is only used at 50%. The connecting rod operates at full load in the combustion stroke. Then, in the other three strokes, the load is low, so in those moments, it is found to be oversized. Now, a two-stroke engine must use the crankcase to draw in the mixture, then pre-compress it to send the mix to the cylinder, and finally recompress and burn. This means that oil cannot be placed in the crankcase, since if there were, it would be dragged into the cylinder and burned. That's why oil is added into the mix, making the engine to pollute. However, this engine completes the cycle in a single revolution of the crankshaft, so the cylinder is used at 100%, producing more power compared to a four-stroke. Now, what if we could combine these two engines into one? Exactly. Let's see in detail how it works. We have a crankshaft like in any engine. The connecting rod is divided into two columns. This connecting rod is attached to the skirt piston, which has no crown. Then we have the crown piston, which has three rings like any other piston. This crown piston is driven by another connecting rod. This other conrod is attached to an arm. The arm has a bearing. This bearing follows a cam with this shape. This cam is connected to the crankshaft. They both spin at the same RPM. Then we have the valves at the top, with camshafts, which also rotate at the same speed as the crankshaft. Remember that in a four-stroke engine, the cams rotate at half speed. Here, too, the same. Now that we've covered all the parts, let's look at its dual cycle. The cycle begins with the piston separated. The crown descends, sucking in the air while the skirt goes up. As soon as the pistons join, the intake valve closes and the compression stroke begins. While the piston travels up, the direct injector adds fuel. The spark is fired and the combustion stroke begins. Power is transmitted to the double connecting rod and to the crankshaft. Going down, when the burn gases no longer have enough useful power to transmit, the exhaust valve opens and the crown rises suddenly, clearing the cylinder. Then the intake valve opens and the exhaust valve closes, starting the intake stroke again. As can be seen, the entire cycle is done in just one turn of the crankshaft. The piston divides to make the exhaust and intake stroke, which are the two cycles where the load on the connecting rod is very low. Then, the pistons come together to receive the full power of the explosion. In a few words, just like a two-stroke engine, the main cylinder now works at 100%. In 2017, after publishing its prototype in 3D, Yan Engines received an investment of $1,320,000, and with this, they invested in research and development to transform an engine. A Ford Fiesta EcoBoost 1-liter engine with 99 horsepower was chosen, because it won 6 consecutive times the award for the engine with the lowest consumption. This means it will be easy to achieve good results. It only has 3 cylinders, making development easier, cheaper, and saving a piston. This engine was modified and tested on the dynamometer with amazing results, giving 20% more power without increasing fuel consumption. Here, we can see the comparison of the piston and connecting rod, original versus D-cycle. Then, to ensure the results, the engine was installed in the Fiesta and used on the street. The test ended confirming the good numbers previously achieved on the dyno. The modified engine withstood the turbocharger pressure without problems. Seeing that the project was on the right track, Yan Engine spoke with the United States Marine Corps, and they gave them an MTVR for testing. This truck is originally equipped with a Caterpillar C12 turbo diesel engine of 11.9 liters and 6 cylinders, generating 425 horses. The engine was modified with the D-cycle system and tested. First, it was forced to idle for a long time. Then, soft acceleration tests were carried out. And by the end of 2019, testing in extreme driving conditions were finished. with final gains of approximately 20% in horsepower. This shows that the D-cycle engine can run on diesel without problems. In the event that this project finally reaches the production line, fuel costs and autonomy could be greatly improved, reducing the cost of everything that is transported by truck. But let's see the disadvantages and problems of this engine. 1. The piston must have a windowed skirt to allow the passage of the auxiliary arm, increasing the pitch of the piston and therefore wear and noise. 2. By having a split piston, the crown separates from the main body and has less surface area for cooling. Let's remember that the combustion chamber works very hot, and limiting the piston cooling may probably result in catastrophic failure. 3. Extra oil injectors must be added below to cool the crown, and with the skirt so low, it is possible that oil leaks into the cylinder. 4. It has more than 5 extra moving parts prone to failure, and above all, the bearing that follows the cam will be required at great load. Place your bets to see how long it lasts. 5. The crown piston will suffer double wear versus the skirt piston since it goes at double speed. 6. The shape of the auxiliary camshaft makes the crown piston run at very high speeds, so it can easily be deduced that it will not be able to rotate at very high revs. That is, if the engine rotated at 7,000 RPM, now it must do so at a maximum of 3,500 and thus prevent the auxiliary piston from exceeding 7,000 cycles. 7. The cams now rotate at twice the speed versus a four-stroke engine, having aggressive ramps for the valves. The intake and exhaust stroke will be performed twice as fast, decreasing gas flow. At high RPM, air won't have enough time to enter the cylinder, resulting in partial charge and therefore reduced power. 9. Due to the short time of the exhaust and intake strokes, overlap timing cams must be used, which will lead to the loss of clean air through the exhaust and poor idling. 10. Personally, I'm very concerned about this piston speed variation. How will the G-forces be? Will it resist? How does this result in vibrations? I couldn't find videos of the tests mentioned by Yan Engines, just some low-resolution photos. The Yan Engines website shows some information, the modified Ford Fiesta, the military truck, among other things. 11. A spring is needed to make the arm with the piston come back. Otherwise, it could float or continue its journey upwards, colliding with the head. The ideal would be a desmodromic system, which translates into even more parts. On the other hand, its advantages are 1. Substantial improvement in the power of an engine on the same displacement, since the cylinder is used twice as many times. 2. This leads to less weight, since the size of the engine can be reduced. 3. Less friction. The crown piston has a smaller skirt and is therefore lighter. Being the only part that moves at high speed, the inertia is reduced. The heavier skirt piston moves slower and only half the time of a four-stroke engine, reducing friction. These improvements give better fuel consumption. 4. It passed the test with turbo and also with diesel. 5. In engines with the camshaft and the block, the piston can be shared with the valve cam, since everything rotates at the same speed and thus save parts. In fact, this was what was done on the Caterpillar engine for the military truck. Do you have faith in this engine? Don't forget to leave your like or a super thanks. That helps me a lot. Comment and share the video with your friends. My name is Francis. Subscribe and see you in the next video.